Thank you. Well, oh, fuck the unmute button. Fuck. God damn it. Belem, hello. I done fucked up already, haven't I? Hello. Belem. Really need a new sound effect other than Blem. For Tang, perhaps. You know, I don't know. I still haven't read that bloody book of Lovecraft things to see what humans think. The humans are like, yes. Yes. Yeah. Okay, so. Hello, everyone. I'm Zoe. And I'm here to do... I've got a weird one. My monitor looks wrong. I've woken up at a weird time. So, of course. And I ran out of games that I needed to revisit, essentially, that were still... horror games, because I keep beating them in one sitting. So, I'm just going to quickly, before we get started on the actual game, we're going to listen to some of the, actually surprisingly, like, hey, music by Simon Poole. You've done quite a good job of making horror music for the park, actually. I wasn't really paying attention to it at the moment, but actually quite a good soundtrack listening to it right now. Credit where it's due. But, after my adventure with the park last Sunday, I talked to my girlfriend about it, who is lots of Lottie, if you don't know, because she was playing Tattletale and she'd gotten quite obsessed with that game, and I'd played that game and got quite obsessed with it as well. And then I mentioned that the park was worse, and she's like, oh, that's that game that's a spin-off to The Secret World. And I was like, excuse me. Anyway, it turns out that, can I get the Steam page for the park quick? Actually, I didn't intend to do this, this particular bit. Oh, not the OARC. Why? Sometimes typing is hard. But yeah, number one, I went back and got all the achievements because there were... No, I did that on stream. What am I talking about? But yeah, in the park, there's this sort of weird mix of, like, attempting to actually horrify you, and stuff like the management is not responsible for diseases contracted via the kissing booth. And I was thinking, why is the game like this? Why is the park designed this way? Why is it like this? And then I realised that it was developed and made by Funcom. And they also made a game called Secret World, which is now Secret World Legends, is a free-to-play game. I did mean to play it because my girlfriend was a big fan of it back in the day. Did not manage to get into it that far, or at all. MMOs are just not my thing, unless I have enough friends who want to play with me at all ways at the same time for it to work out quite that way. But I did do a quick wiki dive. I did look at some videos. I've heard that Secret World is actually surprisingly good, and it is a sort of MMO I think I would probably like if I did play it. Because it's kind of got this goofy horror theme to it, right? And Atlantic Island Park is a location in that game. Now, the park gets into the lore of this fella, the Bogeyman. It's not much lore about the park in the actual Secret World. It's weird, but this fella is a boss in the Secret World. It is definitely... Which explains all of the references that are really on the nose. Apparently the Illuminati controls the island that the park is on. That sort of thing. I'll get into the park wiki in a second, because this one, it's quite on the nose. It explains some of the lore bits, like... Yeah, The freak accidents kept happening where the park was being made. This is all from one cutscene with the guy who currently inherited the park from his definitely not dead bogeyman dad. He's definitely not a... No, it's obvious once you've gone through the park lore. The thing is, it's kind of hard to see the lore from the outside. Also, the bloody ad block doesn't work on the garbage that this fandom.com puts on things. But yeah. Then I went to the park wiki, and it is incredibly verbose. And also, seems to be being written by someone who, now, it's a bit rude to compare this person to the Silent Hill foreskin guy, but I'm getting the same vibe, where this person has enough control over this wiki. The writer, I don't know who actually wrote it, of course, but knowing that they have very much pushed a very particular reading of the park. Things like, this person is clearly pushing against the, oh, it's not actually just inspired by the Babadook came out later, like, bro, that's not why they thought it was about mental illness. But yeah, this gets into it. There's more lore where, yeah, Nicholas Winter is just a rich man who turned himself into a monster. That's pretty clear from the park. But the park itself, it's kind of unclear whether those supernatural elements are real. But with the context that this is also in the secret world, the reason this is so weird is because the bogeyman is just straight up real in this universe. Like, yeah, Nathaniel Winter, apparently he had direct contact with the Illuminati, discovered the supernatural was real. I have no clue where any of this lore comes from, by the way. Like, this is incredibly verbose. This is a really well-written story that is a Wikipedia page, with no sources. But yeah, things like, oh, he went to the thing because a company had already tried to do stuff there and he turned himself into a boogeyman. Using the rides as siphons to get emotions to power his boogeyman powers. Yeah, the Illuminati is like one of the key factions in the secret world, I think. But you go through these wiki pages, which I should probably link, actually, because they are worth a full... Actually, you can find them. They're thepark.fandom.com. Because apparently somebody liked the park enough to make an entire-ass wiki on it. But yeah, and yet things like, oh, the Carnival of Souls and the secret world happens here. At the end, the boogeyman is slain in battle. That is the reason there is no satisfactory conclusion to the boogeyman stuff in the park. It's because this character cannot be dealt with because he's already been dealt with in the secret world. So, there's just no actual solution. Meanwhile, there's a whole load of fucking Chad the Chipmunk stuff. Which is like, oh... Although Chad first appears to be the main antagonist, he's ultimately little more than an extension of the real villain of the story. That's a very charitable reading. I would have just made the boogeyman the only thing. Like, Chad is referenced once in the lore from the secret world. You could have either made him the main antagonist and capitalized on that, or you could have just... Death is, let's be fair, rare at the end. Yeah, the secret world. I'll get onto Lorraine in a second. Yeah, getting all this... I don't know where they got all this lore from. There's no sources. Oh. Chad the Chipmunk has been compared to Freddy Fazbear. Yeah, apparently people thought there was a corpse in there. However, the thing... Also, Chad the Chipmunk is very much a... Honestly, Chad the Chipmunk is a really neat bit of iconography. Like... creepy chipmunk character. Done. But, fucking... Oh yeah, apparently he also shows up in a tie-in thing to do with Lorraine's stuff later. But yeah, it's trying to trick you into thinking that he's the main antagonist. I don't know why. There's no benefit to... Okay, this article just used the term mind rape. This wiki is garbage. And I've been on the Doctor Who wiki, so I know some garbage when I see it. But, yeah, going into this, yeah, there's a whole plot of the park, which is reiterated in every fucking article, to some degree. Yes. But let's get on to Lorraine, the main character. Alias is apparently Mama Duck and the Witch. Where? Goals save Callum.
The thing is, I don't think the developer even cares enough to write this wiki. They'd probably sourced it better. Also, to be fair, the Secret World wiki is nowhere near this complicated. It is right that most of it is conveyed through illusion monologues from unreliable narrators, and that is actually something I give the park credit for. I was crying, shush. The thing is, a lot of this stuff is just kind of... She is definitely the witch by the end of the story, which is weird. Like, here's the thing, yeah, you get all this backstory throughout the game. Don dying on the Ferris wheel. It's weird how this game is done, because, yeah, they got all this backstory, which I'm going to skim over. There's nothing we don't know already. The game itself begins at some point in the 1980s, long after the Parkers have been officially sucked down. Due to her ongoing disconnect with reality, I guess, citation needed. Lorraine is under the impression that the Atlantic Island Park is still open and that she can have something to enjoy. A happy day at the park. He lost his teddy bear. Flirting with him. What really happened is still unknown. In italics in a wiki article. That's good. Callum may have run away from his mother. He may have not. The thing is, it's completely unclear. Rides are working, so I have more power on. Yeah. The thing is, it's worth noting that Atlantic Island Park... It looks completely different in the game The Park to the way it looks in The Secret World. It's not like they designed it to look like The Secret World one, even. It's just different. There's no Hansel and Gretel stuff. There's like a duck boat pond. But it's in the middle of the roller coaster. For some reason. There's another ride that just isn't properly in the park. Like, it looks completely different. There's no massive great fuck-off mountain surrounding everything. Because it's in the middle of a perfectly normal fucking area. This wiki has a solution to this complete and obvious discrepancy. Which isn't just, it happens in a parallel universe. We just use a lot of the iconography because we owned the IP. Which is more likely the thing. Again, it's making the point that this is not the real Chad the Chipmunk for some reason. The monster appears to be manipulating events. Yeah. Yeah, the notes. Why are the notes there? No clue. Why would the bogeyman want to tell Lorraine this based on the stuff that happens later? Yeah. Yeah, eventually she starts being more and more shitty to her son over time. Okay, apparently the bogeyman is actually feeding on her and Callum, who are, I guess, diegetically there. They're not an ideal food source, I guess, but he's a hungry boy, so he's gonna just fuck with them anyway. To feed off their emotions, because that's how boogeymen work, I guess. Yeah, this guy's fucks with them all. Yeah, apparently she hands herself over to the police, who, for some reason, looks like the ticket guy. And also, there's a... You know how he had just a jar with a bee in it at the end of the game? Okay, so... A brief trigger warning on this bit, because Lorraine isn't happy about her son dying because a bogeyman turned her into a magic witch for some reason. Not as she intended to suffer through the prison sentence for Cressy Person Mojo, or if she always meant to kill herself as soon as the trial was over. One way or other, she survives her own suicide because somebody put an immortality bee in her. Somebody put one of the legendary The Bees of Agartha, which means she can't die, in her. Thanks, music. You are conveying my feelings on this. Yeah. Like, she's just got, like, apparently one of the secret world factions were just like, you know what? Let's just shove a fucking bee in this lady. Why do they do this? A thimble. Apparently she possesses a thimble of thimbleful of supernatural talent. Citation needed. Apparently they also shanghaied her to King's police station, erasing the records of fucking hell. Yeah, anyway, the bees use her as a host so she can't die. For reasons. She's immortal and she has magic powers now. She tries to commit suicide and is immediately resurrected repeatedly. But that's in the park, right? Like, that fucking bee is there. This is... The park is held back by the fact that it is tied to the secret world, right? Like, the secret world is... It has horror theming, but it's a horror in the same way Ghostbusters is, where there's occasionally a kind of creepy thing, but it's mostly kind of a goofy romp, right? From what I'm gathering. Like, you can't spray down armies of zombies and be like, oh, that I'm actually scared by this. Like, it's just incompatible with that, the MMO genre. There has to be a degree of cheesy, campy horror. But the park is trying to actually be scary. And that is not a good combination. Anyway, this is just listing ways that she tried to kill herself. Eventually she succeeds, because the plot says she does. There's some sort of dream mission. Yeah, okay. They've also... Again... The trivia section is hot fucking garbage. Yeah, like, the secret world gets that it's supposed to be goofy. But this is trying to do it a serious, deep reading on this. Meanwhile, this wiki is like... Yeah, anyway, she dies because she goes into dreams to fix her bee or something. Good for her. She deserves to be free from this bullshit. God damn. Oh. In the note Don found the House of Horrors, it revealed the possible name was Emma. That's interesting because it doesn't actually connect to anything. I guess it was just because, oh, gender. Sure. For this reason, some have theorized that Emma Smith, whoever that is actually Lorraine's daughter. These rumors remain unconfirmed. That's just weird. Why would they... I mean, I guess if you're going to bring back the protagonist from the fucking park to be in the secret world, it's just like, sure. But then there's this bit here. Unfortunately, some commentators on the park have been left with the impression that the story is simply a story of post-mortem psychosis, deliberately ignoring all supernatural evidence within the game and overlooking the connections with the secret world. As the result, Lorraine has been unfairly demonized across YouTube as an abusive mother and a murderer, rather than the vastly complicated character she actually is. I'm already scaring off my viewers, it's great. Apparently it uses material from her article on the Heroes Wiki as well. Okay. The park is deliberately playing with the idea that you can't quite know what's real. Saying that it is explicitly tied to the secret world, for example, saying that, oh, the park looks different. I don't remember where in this, but it's like, somewhere in... I think it was actually in the... Give me a second. It was in the Bogeyman article, I think. All these articles are massively... Like, a lot of wikis are smart enough to copy-paste stuff from each article to make it easy to comprehend one solid narrative. This one don't. Apparently, yeah... From the moment Lorraine follows her son inside, she finds herself plunged into a dark shadow reflection of the park, one that seems larger than the original site. In all likelihood, she's being drawn into the bogeyman's pocket reality. For the park, it could just be a different universe. It's... No lights. Now, I like the pocket reality theory to an extent, But on the other hand, I want this to be a work of art that speaks for itself. The park should not have to rely on the player knowing fucking secret world lore in order to understand the true meaning. That feels like bullshit to me. I don't think that's fair. I think that because some people like me will play the park knowing fuck all about the secret world and just fucking... Yeah, I feel like there is exactly one person writing this and they're just... No. They don't understand what the tone of wiki pages is supposed to be, and I don't want to criticize them too much because they're clearly just passionate about this, but they are very much pushing one particular interpretation of a piece of work that is deliberately vague and confusing. And although I think they have they haven't cited their sources, so I can't actually tell how much evidence their claims have. And also it doesn't help that the Lorraine Mallard article, completely different from this, doesn't remember to mention the Pocket Universe shit at all. It's just fucking... Because if somebody went into the park and took away a story about mental health that they enjoyed, that resonated with them, then that's just like, fuck it, then it's like... It's not really cool to then say no. Hey Joe, welcome to hell. But yeah, here's the thing. The Boogeyman article explicitly implies that the reason she's getting nastier over time is not that we're discovering more about the character. No. He's using his magic powers to make her worse. No, we can't have a fucking character who just is complex in a way where she's not necessarily a good person. No. Oh no, she has to have been magically manipulated by a ghost. Again, this, I think the park would be actually much better if they'd just made it separate. They could have just made it in a separate universe and used the same iconography. They could have even implied that maybe she played the secret world and she was like, oh, she's taking in ideas from the game. Like, I watched... I can't spoil it, annoyingly, because it's spoilers for the game, but I recently watched a YouTube playthrough of somebody who was playing the third in a series of games where the third one is just set in a parallel universe where the first two are fiction. Like, as a twist. And that's fucking great. That's really interesting. You can just do that, right? Like, it's all fiction anyway. Who gives a shit? You could continue the fictional universe as well as having the weird spin-off thing. Like, fuck it, man. Just... You can use the imagery from Atlantic Island Park if you wanted to, without forcing it to fit into your fucking goofy MMO, which is completely, totally dissonant from the fucking... Anyway, I needed to have this rant, so it was on record. I hope you enjoyed my dive into the park, because... Jesus. They just failed, didn't they? They just had a fucking time of it. Also, I probably haven't properly set up this. I'm going to put on Monster of the Week just while I fiddle with some stream stuff because I forgot to do this earlier. But we're going to play David Cage now. I would genuinely like to play The Secret World at some point, but I'd need friends to do it with, and that means organising stuff with probably Lottie. And we're both quite busy. So fuck knows if we'd be free to stream on the same day at some point. But I the problem is I need with an MMO in particular, I really do need someone to play with. And convincing a group of my friends to play an almost dead MMO's weird reboot decades after the fact it was when it was last relevant, it's a hard ask, let's be honest. Anyway, we're going to play David Cage.
We're gonna play David Cage now. For those of you who were not here last time that I visited the land of David Cage, it's a bad game. It's soft locked on us. Yeah, I was initially intending to, when I was going to come back, plan for it properly and actually go play off camera up to the point that I got to again. But I didn't. I didn't do that. In the end, I just fucking didn't. Okay, make sure it's... Oh, wait, the fucking game isn't in boot yet. It has a stupid launcher. Freaking heck. But yeah, I think I... Oh, fuck. Why is it fucked up my entire screen resolution? David! David Gage! God, you can't even see what's happened to my screen on your end. But, it's just changed the screen resolution of everything.
For no reason.
Let's force stop David Cage's Indigo Prophecy Remastered to try and see. Oh yeah, there's also achievements. Maybe I should get into the achievements. Because I missed all of them. Oh, for fuck's sakes, close the... Control-Alt-Delete. Yeah, I'm going to have to kill David Cage with my own two hands quick. Ah, there we go. Yeah, this is what you expect from the David Cage game, isn't it, huh? This is show what you fucking expect from fucking Indigo Prophecy Remastered. A game that we like to not like. Fucking... What is... More games from... Apparently this launcher has got... I'm just going to change this to screen capture quick so you can see. I just decided, let's look at this launcher for a second. What's here? Oh, login, support, game settings and legal. Apparently Asper, whoever the fuck Asper is, also have ties to whatever all these are? Layers of Fear and Observer, I know, are made by the same company. But it's very, very weird to me that Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords, is somehow associated with the same company as Fahrenheit Indigo Prophecy Remastered, Layers of Fear and Observer. I have a disc copy of that. I've been meaning to get back to it with the mod at some point to restore the lost content, because I actually really loved that game when I played it, but fuck knows if it's any good at this point. Like, it was janky as shit when I played it. Come on, David. David Cage. Yeah, it's changing my resolution to 1024 by 7 something. David Cage. If David Cage doesn't work, I don't think I actually have any horror games left that I haven't played, that I've already played. God, fucking... David! Yeah, the ending was really rushed on KOTOR 2, and it was a mess. I'm going to change it to just screen capture so you can see what the fuck I'm dealing with right now. It's just gone like this. Like, everything on my screen is like this now. I don't know what... I booted this successfully before, right? Like, this... I didn't have this much trouble the last time. I don't know what to do, because it's just dead. Okay, David Cage has had his way, and his way is not working. Oh, yeah, I booted in screen capture and then shifted to the other capture, perhaps. It might be to do with the screen capture. I'm going to do it this way quick. To see if it boots. Yeah, I don't think this game likes to be captured for some bizarre... Okay, you don't see that? Huh. Are you working now, David? David Cage? David? David. God, usually the suffering starts when the game begins, but... if I have to stop the fucking stream to... David. David Cage, please. I just want to play your game, David. David. I like the way that I'm just like, oh yeah, no, David Cage personally caused this problem. Not like the coding staff, the people who made the remaster who probably had nothing to do with him. It's specifically David Cage himself personally trying to attack me right now. No, it's just not booting. There's no reason for this. It's just not working. Just... hey, give me the task manager again. Come on. Oh, fuck my donkey. Yeah, it's gotten worse somehow. Is it... yeah, no, this is fucking... it's not even opening Windows anymore.
Alright.
Hi, Reaganomicon. David Cage has fucking destroyed me. Oh yeah, Joe, I still owe you a raffle game. I've apparently got that written down still. I know you don't want it, but I'm going to keep saying it until you claim something. Oh, fuck me. Alt F4. Alt delete. Okay. So it's just... oh, wait, there we go. Can I get to Task Manager now? No, I can't. Close window. Okay. So, yeah, I'm, because you see the Animal Crossing screenshots hovering on my photos section. Why is this even here? Go away. Just, unpin every group from the start. I don't want this. Why is it here? Also, why is photo, oh, wait, no, I remember. That's how I fixed this problem last time. Bullshit crimes. Now, if I do you, go to desktop one, put the task manager here. Sorted. Yeah. So, I don't think it's worth it. The truth of this is, I genuinely don't think it's fucking worth going through all this trouble to get fucking David Cage games to work. Like, honestly, there are many good playthroughs of it. Like, you know what? Fuck it. Watch Bun's one. Like, Bun did a few streams. I was deliberately not watching them myself because I wanted to play it somewhat fresh myself. But, like, it's just not worth it. This game is just fucking mangled. I loathe it. I want to play you and have fun and you won't let me. The game physically will not let me. I've just uninstalled it out of rage. Fucking hell. Anyway, I don't really have any horror games left at this point that aren't new. Now, I hate breaking my own format, which I deliberately set up to try and avoid. I wanted to make sure I was playing new games every day, every week, right? Like, I was deliberately trying to make a system where I'm actually playing my fucking ridiculous library, but I hate having to, like, I don't like breaking from tradition at all. But I had considered something.
To be fair, I've already played Darkest Dungeon at this point. I'm torn. I'm really torn. Okay. I hate when games just don't work. That's the worst, because I want to play it. Fucking Nora. Anyway, I've got the scary random game set up. Wait, you're not. Fuck it. Right. Okay. I was going to plan this stream better, but this is technically a continuation. I play Among Us with... That's the true horror experience. Oh, yeah, no shit, actually. I didn't log into my stream voice chat. That's hopefully fixed. I usually try to do that, but I have an alternate idea, which is that, with a bit of setup... Where's the... Oh, God, there's so many... I am really out of it. I'm sorry. I'm having a day of this, but... You'll notice my selection of games to play next. I've been trying to do spooky stuff because it's Halloween. Whatever. We've got to beat Christmas at its own fucking game. I'll kill you, Christmas, you bastard. But the only really spooky game is Darkest Dungeon, and I'm not... And Killing Floor 2 is a zombie game, but I've played a lot of Killing Floor 2 yesterday, and I'm a bit burnt out on it. It's less that I'm burnt out on it, and it's more that I'm... going to be burnt out on it if I play any more of it just now. And it's not going to be that much fun to watch unless people are joining again, which is... that's a whole setup thing. I might play it later if, like, Nick or Lottie or whoever is free. Dax, maybe. I don't think Dax is in my voice server yet. Maybe I should probably give them that. But I think I'm torn between two things. Do I have Fortnite installed right now, actually? I only ever play Fortnite with my friend who's obsessed with it. Actually, I have Penumbra installed, don't I? That's a cool... I keep forgetting about that. But if I just quickly dig into my full games folder here... I actually do have a bunch of games that are just, like, here. Some of them from, like, games research. Specifically, these two are very much from literally things that my uni told me to play and I just didn't uninstall. But the Sexy Brutale, actually a good call. Rumbo First Blood, Penumbra Collection. Yeah. They're actually on my computer. That's a fair call. Oh, and Tacoma. Yeah, that's a horror, I think, as well, possibly. But yeah, what I was going to do before you mentioned that was a vote between the true horror is The Wolf Among Us or the true horror is Watch Dogs 2. So, I'm actually going to do a quick three-way vote. I'm sorry that this stream has gone so fucking disastrously already. But, I'm going to create a poll for this. Fuck David Cage. What next? Go a proper vote of it. Because I was saving The Wolf Among Us for when I had Notecam set up. But I have Notecam set up, actually. So I can just do that. Oh, cripes. That's a thing I'm going to need context for in a second, Minerva. Oh, wait, no, of course. Fucking Watch Dogs 2. Ah. Yeah. You're not necessarily wrong about how I hope Watch Dogs 2 is better, but Ubisoft can go fuck themselves still. I've paid no money for Watch Dogs 2, and they will not get any money out of it, hopefully. Okay, I can't fit the whole word in. That's annoying. Start poll. Content does not meet guidelines. Frick, UB. Gonna give you 2 minutes. I'm gonna do a BRB quick. What do you mean doesn't... I also said fuck David Cage. The fuck word is not allowed in polls, everyone. I'll be back momentarily.
still running.
No, good. No, wait, they are. Fuck. Give it 3 seconds, everyone. Okay, apparently the ad's no longer running. I hope that wasn't too long, but fuck. Penumbra one. Oh, that's a real nice mix, actually. But Penumbra is just about one. So I guess I'm playing Penumbra now. Give me a second to actually... David Cage. Betrayed. So... Penumbra. I guess this is kind of a spiritual sequel to... I don't know what... Penumbra Collection. There we go. That works. I did actually play the... For context, I actually did play like the original Amnesia in full on the stream when I was a dumb kid. Who should have probably played something more fun, I guess. But this is the predecessor to Amnesia. And I feel like I played the other... Unpack this zip file before you can run... Oh, okay, no, it's already unzipped. Thanks, text document. Application, there we go. Really hope this is... Welcome to the Penumbra Collection Setup Wizard. God damn it, I didn't realise it was needing installation. It's fine. I'll just skip through this quick. No, don't put it on the fucking C drive. Come on now. No, don't... Not the whole fucking D drive. Put it in MISC programs, Christ. Yes, I would... God, this is an old ass fucking create desktop icon. I'm gonna rename this install files. Cannot because it's in use. Do sure fucking love video games, everyone, am I right? Well, it means that technically speaking, I should maybe go through and install some of the other things that are in here as well as actual full installs. Because clearly if I go into fucking Tacoma, it'll be like, oh, we haven't installed that yet either. Jesus. But yeah, the point is, I technically did stream... the spiritual successor to this? And did I... No, they made... I did not stream that game. The sci-fi one they did. Which is bloody good, and you should play it. But like, I didn't actually play it on stream. That was before I was streaming, I believe. So hopefully, we should be good. But fuck knows, honestly. Like, video games are like this, huh? Just have to install a fucking game on stream sometimes because David Cage betrays you. Open install OpenAL? What the fuck's OpenAL? Fuck no, go away. Oh, it's just giving me all three Penumbra games. I guess. Okay, so who knows... Okay, so, oh yeah. Overture Part 1, play Black Page Part 2, and Part 2 expansion is Requiem, I guess. So, open source audio library usable, almost everyone. Maybe I should have installed that then, huh? God, this installer has a lot of things, like, when it was like, install desktop icons, it wasn't like... install, tick the box to install desktop icons. It was like, what it said was, install desktop icons ? With the tick box. Like, I probably do have it installed already, but there's a small chance I don't. And that would be a bit bad. Huh. Where the fucking Penumbra, there we are. Are you showing up, Penumbra? Oh, it's typing at me. God damn it. Fucking, oh, no. Fit to screen. There we go. That's That hopefully looks deliberate. There we go. I missed all that fucking text, huh? Oh, they're also telling me to fucking... Oh, yeah, no, sorry, yeah, right. Thank you. Yeah, the edges aren't as clear on my side as yours, sadly. Yeah, there you go. Welcome to Penumbra's Overture. I'm going to drop the volume over there. This is fucking loud as shit on my end. Time for a spooky fucking thing. I didn't actually see the fucking intro title sequence, so I'm actually going to exit it just to fucking temporarily actually see the intro of that game. I hope this works. Who fucking knows, though, right? Oh, things I need of you. I may wish to do, but please do not make the same mistakes I did. My father, Howard, deserted me before I was born. I could claim the loss of my mother, and the letter I received after her funeral blinded me to what I had to do. It would be a lie. Human nature sealed my downfall. My name is Philip. If you are lucky that by the time you receive this, I will be dead. If fate frowns, we will all perish. Thanks, Phil. Oh, buddy, old pal. There's no webcam on right now. My webcam should be on right now. Got the wrong... Give me a second. I can turn on note camera at any second, but it'll be wrong with me. But yeah. Anyway, options. Can I fuck with anything? It's fine. Sound. Can you just be quieter in general, please? Can you... Don't know what that... Don't know why, if I want that on or off, to be honest. Sorry. Oh, it lets me choose what output I'm going to, I guess.
Boo.
Ah, who fucked?
It's the ghost of Philip.
God damn it, Philip. I can't adjust the sound volume, so you might be drowned out horribly. Oh, right-clicking lowers it.
Okay,
wait, give me a second. Right, drop it to like 50 fucking percent, because it's so fucking loud. Say things, C.
Say things.
Okay, right, that's better. Okay, yeah, it's sound
everything. I'm eating Christmas chocolate at the moment.
It's... How dare you, this is a Halloween stream only. No Christmas allowed.
That's why it's so
spooky. We're banned from Christmas.
No.
Christmas is banned.
Oh. We never celebrated Halloween as a family, though, so... It's not
That's why we're losing the war, see?
Oh, yeah, nice to have company, I guess.
Good-o. Yeah.
Anyway,
it's
like, oh.
Philip, the ghost.
Can I just not do a specific one? Because I've forgotten which is... Go. If I'm not careful, it's going to send the wrong fucking thing now. And I won't be able to hear the fucking game. Oof. Come on, front headphones. There's no there. Front headphones. Alright, I need to... graphics. Oh. Oh, good, I can actually put it up to a reasonable thing, meaning that all my tweaking is just okay, yeah, no, my microphone's a bit not that sensitive. I'm gonna just drop the whole thing. See, say things.
Thing.
Yeah, okay, that's about, I think we're about even now.
Ow.
I hope. The game, oh. I'm gonna have to restart the game because I want to improve the fucking graphics, I guess.
Nice.
Yeah, advanced. Mm-hmm. Oh, good. I can fuck with things. This is an old game. I can literally just...
I also can't see anymore because I'm on Discord.
Oh, yeah, shit. No, good point. Let me just finish fiddling with the settings of this game I've literally just installed.
What you're doing.
Video games, friend.
Okay. Twitch drop on the blah, blah, blah.
No, don't worry. No, I'll give you a side stream once I've boosted the game.
I'll get on my phone as well so I can read chat.
Valid. And that also gives me more viewers. Thanks, C.
Yeah.
This is probably too big for the actual setup now because I fixed it and now it's unfixed its fucking self. Penumbra, meet the... God, Penumbra is wonky as shit.
Penumbra.
Stream, there we go.
And do you even lift Penumbra?
Just getting the screen applications. It's not detecting it as an application. On stream. No, I don't want to keep you... Right, you're just getting my whole screen, see?
Like
don't
I'm
tell anyone about
my
dirty
phone.
Porn collection. Any
oh my god, all this porn.
So much fucking porn, I know.
Oh my gosh. So filthy.
Well, David Cage betrayed me. Everyone betray me. My story began in February, year 2000. Ooh. Space year 2000, ooh. Everyone.
That's archaic, 2000.
From my part to this allegory, I'm not going to make the same mistakes my father made. I would vanish from my mother's life before I was even in it. So when he sent me a letter a few days after Mum's funeral, it was the first I'd ever heard from him. Pity he was dead. Writing from beyond the grave must be a genetic habit in my bloodline. His letter contained a key, instructions, pleas for forgiveness. I figured the dead don't have much use for absolution, so I turned to his prophetic passing, which he inexplicably expected to come any day.
God, this man just not talk like something for 2000.
Clearly averse to explanations, my father preferred to leave directions to a bank on Mayfair I'd never even heard of. In that bank was a safety deposit box in his name, and myself as executor. Of course, I went as he knew I would. I discovered that despite the evidence, he'd been legally declared dead almost 30 years ago. And so the old book and collection of notes I found had, in the eyes of the law, been mine all this time. My father's instructions were to burn the documents, raise no further questions. But that was his error. No man's immune to the shameful trappings of curiosity, and my humanity got the better of me. The university I taught at was world-renowned for two things, physics and linguistics. I represented the first, and the man who stood for the second was stumped by my recent acquisition. The book was indecipherable. The notes, however, showed a location somewhere in uninhabited northern Greenland. It took me almost a year to book the last flight I'd ever take. As I watched civilization disappear along with Heathrow, I realized my father had disappeared 3 decades ago, almost to the day. And I considered in turn what it was that I was leaving behind. We landed on a strip of ice a few feet wide, and within minutes I was pulling away on a chartered boat, beginning the 12-hour journey that would lead me into my past.
Yeah, this feels like it's been written by a Victorian, which is weird. It feels like that was a guy talking about. Finally, this doctor had been stealing my gear. Yeah, far from home, but just pick things up using left mouse. Oh.
Left mouse.
Oh, that's some Jake Daniels. Fuck. Oh. My Jake Daniels.
No, that was expensive.
Oh my god, this is actually really fucking laggy. Why is that so laggy? It's a fucking old ass game. We have to see. Hello?
Hello?
Did I hear a voice or am I hallucinating?
It's the ghost of Philip.
Fucking Philip again. Christ.
Why did you break my Jack Daniels?
God, I'm going to have to now quit the fucking game in order to get the graphics working. God, PC gaming, who does this shit? What sort of bastard man would do this to me?
Hey, it's me. Oh, I'm gone.
Wow.
I was famous for a second.
God, fuck this Victorian ass piss man. I wanna. Oh, I didn't save. Auto saves? No. No. Favorite saves.
Gosh, John fucked up.
Can I skip this bastard
Probably not.
Oh, thank fuck I did.
Oh, surprising. Good. Detracting is back.
Oh god, the job. I'm almost docked, right? That's smooth enough, right? But at least I get to look at my Jake Dean. My Jake Daniels.
Jake,
oh fuck! Oh. I keep pressing right mouse and that happens.
Yeah.
Well, I'm getting some screen tearing, actually. Good note to jot down notes. And reminders.
Thanks.
Okay. Let me. I think I left a torch in my ice skip to it. Anyway, let's look at this combo soup. I bet this is not. Come on.
Yeah.
Just want to look at your fucking soup, mate. Let me look at the soup.
Cut out the soup collection.
God, this is very amnesia already. Let me see my soup. Oh.
It's magical.
Uncle soup. Cthulhu's squid soup.
It's my soup. I'm Cthulhu. We've established this, by the way.
Are you? Okay. That's.
Did you never listen to my little segment of the stream where you left?
No, I didn't. You've just confessed this to me. I was trying to carry a key. Mine's
nothing.
In the inventory. God, it just freezes you whenever I fucking. Let me use the key.
How do I?
My fitness expected.
You have to put it in the
battery left. Oh my god! Is it like fucking hell?
Yeah.
You have to map it to the bar. What the? Not much light here. My flashlight can come in handy. Oh,
nice.
Let me have my batteries.
This is not a flashlight.
Yeah, this game has aged. I'm sure the map is good decades out of date. But landmarks don't change much in Greenland. Good old uncivilized Greenland.
Yeah, it's just a field, ain't it?
It's a field, nothing else. Yeah, like that's how Greenland works, right? Oh, good, more whiskey. This dude brought two
extra
fucking bottles of Jake Daniels.
Oh. Be careful, don't drop that. It's the only bottle we've got left.
Yeah, gotta be careful with my Jake Daniels. I need to look at this. I'm really curious about like the. Oh, it's the same label on each side. This is just a Photoshop Jack Daniels bottle, isn't it?
Yeah.
They weren't even trying with this.
I could do better than that.
Honestly, I think I could do better than that. That's not very good. Oh, good, a flosh lid. Yeah, apparently I have to map it in my fucking inventory? Okay, sure. And I've got a padlock still!
Oh, you got those lights that you snap and they fluorescent. What are they called?
The glow stick.
Glow stick!
Playboy poster. It's nice, some things don't change no matter how far you are from home. That's not a poster, that's a fucking Polaroid.
I prefer the fish poster. Poster is very sexy.
This life ring has a thing in the middle of it, missing the point of a flashlight. Dear listener, just a quick note before you said. The life ring is moving on its own.
Ghosts! It's ghosts!
Just a quick note before you set sail and leave me once again. I left a little something to remember me by in the chest at the foot of your bed. I don't know, you still have one bed on board, taking shifts because there is no way to get your rest. What does a fisherman's wife know of life at sea? I'll be praying every night for you to make the catch you need so that you can come home to me safely. And soon. Please don't be gone for 5 weeks like last time. Fuck, woman. Get another husband.
You deserve better.
You deserve better. Dump him. Good for always that time. I know he might nag sometimes, but I do love you, you know. I've washed those overalls of yours. I know you get them covered in assorted fish parts in no time. But it seems a bit better knowing that they've had a wash. But I've left the Henriksons in the village. I've asked them to see if you're coming by any trout, but I said they were mostly out of season. If you happen upon any, don't say anything. Stow them well in the eyes. I'll do something special with them to celebrate when you come home to me. A ship's captain deserves a little special treatment every once in a while. Take care, my love.
She's just telling you to openly lie.
I feel like this man fucks the fish, and I don't know why.
he's got a fish poster next to his Playboy posters.
Actually, you're not wrong.
And there's some sexy fish.
God, the screen tearing is really bad. Is there a way to fix that?
Oh.
No shader quality. I don't think there is.
Motion blur. V-sync. That's removing the image tearing. Is that helping? Yeah, oh, that's so much better.
Nice.
Why is that all my fucking default? Christ. I said for the boats and you had the blizzard fall around me. I was ignorant of the bedline with the judging my father's part. I had no idea what to expect, so not my concern was just fine. And no way that I lost my orientation from my spirit first. I lost strength from the extremities to about that. I knew half of them was, oh my god, I just realised why this sounds so antiquated. It's... So I've not read much actual H.P. Lovecraft. I have this big-ass book of H.P. Lovecraft. I'm just gonna... drop my stuff everywhere, trying to demonstrate how heavy it is. Okay, just, I'm gonna aim the microphone down.
Oh yes, ASMR, my
just to be, just to be clear how heavy this fucking thing is. It's this whole complete edition, it's hardback. It's gorgeous. More gorgeous than anything to do with H.P. Lovecraft previously. Oh, fucking horrible racism. But,
oof, that would have been.
Who's texting me? Oh, it's the fucking NHS again. Fuck off, mate. Oh shit, I've bent my headphone jack.
No!
Oh, Jesus. Don't want your fucking app, NHS. That joke should be said, I'm just gonna bend my headphone jack back to my shit. Oh,
okay.
Jesus. Well, that's, I'm gonna pretend that's fixed and not think about it any longer.
Yeah, I'll do it.
I mean, to be fair, I possibly should get the app if it's actually good, but, like, I don't want more apps on my phone, ever.
I can't get the app because my phone won't update to the latest iOS.
Yeah, that's also a thing, but...
My sister's got it, though, so I just use hers.
I'm honestly lucky that my OnePlus hasn't become outdated yet. OnePlus are good for that. They're an Android phone. They're very good. They're a company that I actually kind of like, which is very rare with me. Anyway.
I have an iPhone 6.
Sorry, my point before I got distracted there is...
yes.
There's a man called H.P. Lovecraft, and he did a lot of racism in a lot of books.
The boy. The myth and the legend.
The racist. I've read a bit of his stuff. The racist is mostly the takeaway you should take from it. But he's quite popular in his writing. I read a bit of his stuff. I did not get very far into his work because I was reading it at bedtime, so I got fed up with him. But this is written like an H.P. Lovecraft story. That's why it feels old and antiquated and weird, is because it's written like he wrote. And by that I mean I'm not a fan, thus far, of the writing style, because it reminds me of his shitty story where he got lost in a cave and pissed his pants. So cool. Didn't really have much to say.
iPhone 5S, Joe! You archaic or something?
Holy
get
shit!
Get a new phone, Joe!
Man's so racist that other races ask him to cool it with the racism. You're not wrong, but... Oh, Christ. The game should be... The game sound is at 50%! What the fuck?
It's just a loud voice.
Is it just because I'm not... Do you want me to just be close to the microphone, I guess? Is that going to help? I can interact with things.
The microphone.
Time to throw rocks.
Yeet.
Remember when everyone was pretending to be really, really scared of Amnesia? And by pretending, I mean they probably were, actually, because it was quite a scary game when you're in the moment. But, like, that was one of those games that got, like, multiple YouTubers their start as the guy who got scared of things. The hell is that?
PewDiePie.
I don't care. I need shelter. I wasn't going to say the name of the other racist, but... Oh, look. I guess that... Oh, no. It's a thing. I'm cold, and I've found a thing in this trench that I can't leave. So... Yeah,
guess
I'm not...
Go
this is not
the
as...
Thing.
This is... Used interact mode, I can swing the stone more accurately. As in the... Oh, I see. There's a button... You can just... It's too far away. Can I... Oh, my stone. Yeah, if you hit R while holding a thing, you can do... That's fun.
Hello. Let's go into the vault.
Can you let me... I, this is... I kind of like this weirdness.
Mm. It also goes kind of...
Is it clockwise or counterclockwise?
Oh, pants open. There we go. Oop. Loading.
Just jumps in like... Ladders, don't need those. Buy kneecaps. My shins are going to snap when I hit the floor.
What the fuck are these sound effects? You can't hear, but like, this time there's noises.
Which
I'm hoping are louder on everyone else's end because I can't fucking hear them now, apparently. Yeah, this looks like an amnesia game, doesn't it? Except bad. I fell! Oh no, the ladder broke. Looking around, maybe I didn't.
Oh,
what is this place? This is a barrel. Like, could be anything inside it.
A human corpse.
Oof, come on. Oh, it's so heavy. Oh, I can barely move it. Ugh.
Ugh.
Is that ammunition? Empty box of ammunition. What is this place? I mean, quite blatantly some sort of... Why is it in English?
It's like a mine.
Yeah, I mean, most games are better when you don't know how actually dangerous they are. Like, this is my... I'm still stand by that Amnesia Machine for Pigs would be a lot more well-regarded if people hadn't realised en masse that there's barely any actual threat in that game to begin with. Like, I need to go back to it as well. But I'm with that game, it's like, oh, I know people who worked on this. I don't know how well they like me anymore. I could probably finagle them into joining me on stream. And that might be fun. So I'm putting off actually playing them as a result. Oh, shit. Oh, free hammer. Oh, apparently I can hold right mouse button to... Oh, crap. This game is a little bit jankalicious.
Janky.
Anyway, I guess I have a hammer now.
Nice. Get your pickaxe, diamond pickaxe, and
if
mine.
If I hold L, my hammer. Oh God, I don't get the controls of this game. But I have a hammer, and that's how. I think the thing is, it'll probably help with the actual horror of it, because it's not that I can't actually defend myself in the game universe, it's that I'm this is the incompetence of my character. Oh, 24 hour ration packs that are expired. I'm stuck, there's something in the way.
There was like the wood, you could like smack the woods behind the book,
oh,
the shelf.
Definitely, yeah. No backseat gaming, see.
Oh, sorry. I'm just excited because I did a big trade. I don't usually.
Oh my god! You have to actually physically go woof with it.
Oh, that's not how you use a hammer.
You whack it. You do a big whack on it. You have to physically do the whacky with the mouse.
Whacky.
Is there a crouch button? Yes, there is. They didn't tell me the crouch button, unfortunately. But
ooh.
Oh, we're going into a pipe that looks. This is very amnesia in itself. I remember something like this in Amnesia. Industrial mechanism. Put a thing in the hole. Hi, friend.
Hello.
There's nothing in there.
Ghosts.
Hatch is solid. It won't open by hand. What if I gave it a blackie? Oh, fuck yeah. Buy barrels.
No. What'd they ever do to you?
Everything. I'm not standing up yet. There we go. I've opened the door. But I see it's a crank. You gotta go through the crank is how you... The crank is how you open the door. So I need to find
the crank.
The crank
is how you crank.
Yeah, you gotta crank the crank. And pull the shift and mouse trap. That's how that works, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't... Yeah, the thing is, I think he's just like, my dad made a map to show that there's things. And fuck is the layout of this map?
Yeah,
is
it
this
was
just a
vague.
Maze that leads to the same place? Yeah, these two paths both lead to the same place. That's an illusion of fucking choice if I ever saw one.
Oh, I bet it's the fucking pipe, isn't it?
Pipe.
Smack it a few times, I'm sure it'll work.
I don't think people actually liked Mousetrap the game. I think people just liked the ability to build a thing, in truth.
Mousetrap was great. I actually got it to work once.
Oh, you can combine things. It's like a point of adventure, I guess. Yeah, I've added a rod. Whoa. Oh, okay.
Speedy.
Oh, I can do the lean. Oh, come on, dude. Let me push my rod.
Let me touch my rod.
Well, I'm a white person, so I'm going to wander into things like an idiot.
Dude.
This is how horror films work, right? What far is this ending into? It's 100 feet below ground, just by two solid metal hatches, located in a remote Antarctic Arctic wilderness, and buried underneath the snow. I don't know what I expected, but it feels something I hadn't felt since I was a child. I never gave it much thought before, but I realised that our entire society is a network of safety nets, emergencies. God, fuck. Yeah, unfortunately, the tone of the David Cage intro has really put me in the wrong mindset to be enjoying this.
Is it someone else? Eric, who hurt you, Eric?
Fucking Eric. He's Eric now. I don't care who his actual name was.
Called Eric. Is he Philip?
I think it's Philip. It's, you know, his dad was Howard and he's Philip. So Howard Philip Lovecraft.
And that letter was Eric. Unless that was someone else's stuff where he just
his
like...
this fucker has to name his kid Lovecraft. Like his first name. What the fuck, dude? He has an entire society network of safety nets, emergency services, and then the phone line, hidden safety in the workplace, friends, family, lovers, all there if something goes wrong. Part of a carefully designed structure to present all of the most mundane of emotions. Once again, I felt like I did when I was in school, so I had my closing ring of older kids, and anything might happen to me, friends, were too scared or too far away. God, this is...
His thing.
This is
you?
Both a mood as an anarchist-leaning lady, and also, fuck you, Tyler Durden. Get a fucking job.
Oh yeah, the Eric was the fisherman we stole from him. That's why I got confused.
Oh yeah, we've robbed a man. Yeah. We haven't seen any other people yet either, actually. This is... Oh, more beer. There could be anything going down here. Rogues are horrible guys and failures. I'm taking chances if I face again here in just a second. And here's me. I need to do a crouch. God, this is very much Tell Not Show. I get it, because it's the first time they did this game, but Amnesia, despite being more vague on what your actual mechanics are, is way better.
Yeah, it actually like gets you to...
Yeah, it gets you to discover it by them making a game where they expect you to know the mechanics already. They accidentally made a game that teaches you how to... And maybe they did it more deliberately as well, but like, Amnesia does a better job of teaching you how to play this sort of game. This one does, I feel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it seems like a lot of like just telling you what to do. So
yeah, it's just telling you what to do
with
this wordy ass fucking Lovecraft Durden boy.
Makes me think of the narrator from Frankenstein who really pissed me off when I studied it in A level.
Because
he was Frankenstein, you know from Frankenstein.
Frankenstein from Frankenstein. Victor.
You know, Dr. Frankenstein.
Yeah, Victor Frankenstein. He's not a doctor. He's. Well, you clearly don't. You just. What
well,
sort of fake Franken fan are you?
I clearly didn't pay attention because the narrator was so pissy that I just didn't.
Oh, God, yeah.
Didn't listen to the. Or like,
to be fair, I think that's supposed to deliver it, but also, like, yeah, it is.
Just like feel bad for me, nah, mate. You're a little bitch.
So much history in this place, tied up in words and less to decompose. Fuck you. I'm fed up with this fucking man. Command. We're the Germans haven't. It's an English base in Greenland for a war. I guess is what I'm getting from this. I'm just skimming. I don't care. God, I am just so much not in the right mood. Like. Oh, I touched the lantern and my eyes. This is in Amnesia as well. This man, an old man, close to unseen. He's strange, yet he is no stranger. I've seen him before. I still know this man before him. He's Howard. I call him Father. Victor makes a living creature and realizes he's not ready to be a dad and has a breakdown and changes uni major.
Oh,
fucking God.
He did, though.
What the hell just happened? I saw my dad in a very vivid cutscene that I saw. Again, this game is very much doing things that they needed to do in order to perfect Amnesia to be such a good game. Like, Amnesia, like, it's probably aged really poorly. It's been played to death. But that game's genuinely good. Like, it's locked. I need a key. Oh, do you now?
Yeah. Just wrap that shit up. It's technically opening, like, a tiny bit.
A tiny bit, you say?
Oh my god, I can't believe it let you do that.
I can't believe it let me do that too. That's fucking great. A big book of explosives. Oh, it's teaching me how to make explosives. Bantrix, black gun, powder, and string. Okay, that's the puzzle then. The string coats in the adhesive, and then put in the gunpowder. Dynamite made of this stuff. I can do this later.
BTS is dynamite.
It's telling me I need to make explosives. Oh, peels! But yeah, Amnesia as a game is real good, right? Like, it's a very well-executed horror experience. It's... If horror didn't age so badly... Because the problem with horror is it needs to subvert expectations, and once you've set those expectations by making a good horror film, everyone's going to rip it off. It becomes the norm, right? Like, you can't... It's hard to watch old horror films because they're all like, it's stuff that's already been done. You can appreciate them what they are, but they'll... If you watch old Friday 13th sort of things. But like... Oh god, is there something else down here with me? I can just wait here. Oh, it's dog.
Friend?
Puppy! Oh, it's just Puppy. Hello, Puppy. Jeez, I've never been this scared in my life. God, pet this kid! Dog. I'm sure if it ever has, but I better stare at it. And with my field of vision might panic me, and then I'm a goner. Oh, he's so scared of Poopy.
Dog.
He's Poopy.
Werewolves.
He's just Poopy.
It's just a puppy. It's just a puppy.
Just a Poopy.
Forbidden Obu.
It's Poopy. I know, they're doing the thing where it's like you go back to a place and things have changed. That's nice. That's a nice standard. Yep. I jotted down a note just in case.
Just in case?
Of what? God,
in
fucking...
case the poppy takes my brain. I don't know.
God, I feel like I'm jacking my computer off doing this. God damn. There's a reason they removed this from the later game. God.
This door is
God,
too
I'm
strong.
Actually tired from doing that. Jesus Christ. Oh, fucking hell. But yeah, like, my point is, this game is them playing with ideas that would later become good in Amnesia, essentially. Like, this game is so good because Amnesia is so good because this game existed to be an experimental ground. And as I also say that, I can't remember the name of the other one they did, the sci-fi one. Off the top of my head, but I played that too, and that one is also arguably an improvement. Ooh, signposting. Thanks, game.
Wait, I'll Google it.
Yeah, Soma. Thank you, Panda. Also, hi, Panda.
Thank
you. I'm nice to miss you joining.
How well?
The swing weapon thing is... Bear in mind I'm just pulling my mouse backwards and forward and he's flailing it like a fucking... What's the use of junk? This best to be a decent hiding spot.
Sorry, apparently you're the number one Penumbra stream on Twitch right now.
I love being the number one Penumbra Twitch streamer on Twitch right now. Good job these signs all fell pointing the right direction, huh? I shouldn't be calling that out. That's benefiting no one but me.
Bye,
everyone. Oh, hi, it's me. I didn't say hi to me. Hi, me. Hi, everyone. I do try to say hi to people. I'm trying to be a good interaction streamer because I'm small enough that I can, but also, God, all these great paint.
Let's drink the lead paint.
No. See, we can't.
It's tasty.
If the light wasn't empty, it'd be a handy thing to have. Oh. Bugs equals sad face.
Sad face.
Lighter plus fuel equals kaboom, smiley face. Who are they fucking hired this?
Consume the forbidden sauce, sorry.
The forbidden sauce? No! You can't. Reams of wiring. Really? Reams? Is that the one you're going with?
Would it be like toils?
Paper boxes, rusty nails. Coils, okay. I would have said, yeah.
Coils. I said toils, fish. I was close enough.
And fish. Oh, I just left the room I just entered.
Eat.
Ah, my eyes. Ah. God, they tell you to play it in a dark room and then they flash you whenever you open a door. Fucking hell. Ooh, the rock box.
It's my house. It's where I live.
What does that mean?
I live in the rock box.
Why do you live in the rock box?
I don't know. Because I am a pebble.
Reams also count paper. Reams or Causa. They're both right, but I feel that Reams feels more outdated.
Reams feels like reams of ribbon.
Yeah.
Like strips.
Oh, I found more drug. I've not even. Nice. I found the wine cellar and I found another paint. Hallucination. Ah! Come on.
Oh.
It was different, but the same that time. Like, I had more control, but over what? We didn't do anything, friend.
Ah.
It's not giving me more information. I may never get used to that. Are you sure, friend? Because. Trying to descend. A stalker transporting ore, I suppose. There's a draft coming from the base. Oh, I see. Oh, there's an ore door.
A trap deer.
Found the ore door.
Open sesame.
This is setting a bad precedent.
Smash your way in.
Are they save points? Because I don't know what they are. Deeper rock to some kind of basement. Okay. Can I...
The sex dungeon.
Yes, of course it's the sex. I hate that it freezes whenever he moves. Come on, okay, no, now it opens. Okie dokie. There, door open. I'm not going down there until I've explored other bits of this building. But... Locked from the other side. That means someone's still inside. I hear chattering. Why won't he open the door? Why do you presume it's a dude?
Knock, knock,
knock. Knock. It's me. I'm not a threat.
Just smashing through like you're in The Shining.
Shining, yeah.
It's Johnny.
It's me. Oh, the whispering's nice and creepy. That's nice sound design.
I love me some ASMR.
Well, I enjoy this. I'm just destroying historical artifacts at this point. Like, I'm like the British Empire.
You are though, kind of. You came from.
Fuck this statue. Looks as cage. I was tunneled through more recently though. What sort of creature makes these markings? God, you could just. It's not very. The subtlety really needs work. Like, Things like, oh, look at these markings, aren't they creepy? I don't like spiders.
God. You don't like anything.
Ah, my eyes. Why did you... Oh, are the flashes the autosave?
Maybe.
Steam can blister flesh from bone in an instant. Death is the final unknown.
Wow, edgy much.
Sure hope that was an autosave, because I don't know how to manually save.
Yeah, I think it was.
Oh, thank fuck. Anyway, I can't get through the steam. Steam could blister flesh from bone, you know.
Died.
Hope there's no more wolf.
Puppies.
I can't pick things up while holding things. It's annoying.
I'll send it to later.
I begin this record in hope that the great work we have undertaken here might one day be of scientific value. Despite the chaos which ensued in the 6 hours previous, my aim is to remain secure until what I hope there may be arrives. I have barricaded myself in a small workshop area in the abandoned part of the mine. Hope the menagerie meager food rations here will keep me alive. That's a lot of keep me alive in small space. Is it? I'm breaking.
Oh no.
Again, I do need to get back to Machine for Pigs.
So Arena's suspiciously small hammer is like the Tesco value Thor.
Christ! Jim's but curse with blah blah. Oh, there's a thing. Oh, I'm scientific. I thought I was to say the rescuers would arrive. They didn't. Oh no. I went out. Oh. Don't make assumptions, friends. Mm-hmm. I left the workshop and. He's trying to build up a sort of uncanny fear of what you're being told in these, but it's not working outnumbered by the beasts. It's a fucking wolf, dude.
It's a puppy.
He's injured his ankle. Oh no! He's like a Doctor Who companion from the 60s.
Every little helps. Oh my gosh.
Be scared of the dog. So, my lesson learned. Only six spiders in it. I do not like spiders. God, mm-hmm. There's so many days going by, actually. I like that it's doing a sort of sense of time passing with the different diary entries. Because I had this in my open mouth and I woke up this morning. I swallowed it. Not so much the actor swallowing, it concerns me with the genus of arachnid. I like that cave grown swallowed with venomous and instant dream, the point of Charles and all the things. Any known venom would affect me by now, and today the first minor cause of celebration I've had since the incident. I ate a spider, sure hope I'm not poisoned. Very mission when the only time I'd virtually inexhaustible supply of nutrition. I intend to venture into the base and read the story in the name of science to hear more about these creatures' natural habits. For 4 days now, I've been spying spider with quite considerable sustenance provided by the spiders. Sometimes I was struggling to gather enough of the crunchy little morsels. However, late luck smiled me, and once more, when the batteries of my torch died, in my second. Finding the creature's natural habitat is the dark. My life now diminished. I need to only lie still for a few minutes. I'll have attracted enough the beast for a rather hearty meal.
Okay. Tasty!
He loved that crunch.
Just gotta dip it in some paint. It would be the perfect snack.
He's just hung. Yeah, have a bit of the forbidden sauce, bit of the spider beef.
Oh
my god. That's a horrible sight. Or mummifier smell. No, really awful.
Puppy!
Jesus, the spiders ate the dog. That's okay, so now it's doing quite a good job. Those things, they bit long-winded, but they set up the actual reason to be fucking scared without the protagonist being like, what the fuck? Why is your thing? Why is there a ladder here? Can I move that? Can I move the ladder? Dude, move the
Nah, you're too weak.
Good, I can move this ladder will be helpful.
Let's go, not a friend.
Yeah. This will get me out, right? Like, I've got a ladder now, I can go out of the broken thing. I'm no longer trapped in this basement. I'm good. God, I bet there's a specific place you're supposed to put this, actually. Is it here? It's there! Hooray! Now I can escape the hole! I don't want to, though, because I want to see if there's more spider.
You want to smack the spider with your spider. Tiny hand.
Bethesda is good at... Yeah, no. I do have a lot of problems with more the company Bethesda than their games, in truth. But, like... what was the... There was an I. Why was there an I? I need to stop carrying my hammer around if I'm not using it. It's not benefiting me. Like, they are actually pretty decent at environmental storytelling. Like, a company that was less good at it would not have attempted Fallout 76. Like, they wouldn't have even tried. Mm-hmm. And, like, 76, despite all its flaws, I do think that has some good and sound storytelling in there.
Again, I'm dating the Fallout 76 defender, so pinch of salt. But, like... Oh, shit. Don't murder me. That's rude. Day 71. My other assumption and benign nature of my cellmates may have been an error. Careful also, I'm concerned that there may be a small volume of natural chemicals stored in my stomach, which, if just a regular period of time, may become psychotropic or even lethal. My only real chance is to break out of here and raid any stash of supplies I can find. However, the evidence against the movie is insurmountable. One, I have no source of light. Two, I swore to myself I wouldn't leave until I heard the human voices outside. Three, the spiders are so tasty.
Damn. Is he getting high on spiders?
He's high off spiders.
Nice.
Infinite spider juice. Yeah.
Don't need weed, just need spider juice.
Yeah. I've just marked the maiden walls. My scribbled diary entries, which in the dark may amount to an inedible scrawl. Today is the 100th day of my new life. I wish that they'd actually... I mean, I get it's good for accessibility that they... and translating it, that this isn't in written text, but it would be way more... It would be kind of more effective if it was horribly scrawled and you had to open up the sort of visual overlay.
Yeah, yeah. I know what you mean.
Yeah. Again, that's technical limitation. That's nitpicking. Over the past month, my edible friends have become more and more aggressive. I wonder why! And have swelled number and size. Whether or not this is on my plundering their ecosystem, I am unsure. However, at this rate of growth, they will soon be too large to crawl through the gaps in the walls. For right now, I can only see the tip of the iceberg. If all fails, I will, and I am never recovered. I hope at least that my study of, and indeed involvement with, these fascinating creatures will one day be regarded as an important point in natural history. The greatest names in modern science got there more through fluke than talent, and it appears that this rule extends to my discovery of this delicious new species. I only pray for the second rule deems my breakthrough too insignificant. All great discoveries tend to consume their inventor. Yeah, no, this dude's fucked up fucking.
Well,
for
the size of these,
I say it looks like eggshells. That's a, yeah. I mean, I get
because
the graphic limitations are why you've had to say that. Yeah, no, that's definitely an eggshell, huh? This is. Oh, fucking.
Ah.
I wish I could. I think they've deliberately done this in an area where you have to be crouching so that you can't quite. Oh, wait, no, tab. Sorry. I'm as fit as going to be expected. You've just walked through steam, my dude. At least he's got some delicious beef jerky.
Yum. Not as tasty as spiders.
That would have worked better if we hadn't found any food until after the spider bit. Maybe. Oh, a padlock. How could I possibly get past that? It is a mystery. Finally, what's that rather work? It's literally saying, yeah, smash the fucking pot, dude. There we go. Yay, lighter fluid and paint. Hospital grade.
Drink the paint.
Delicious. Also, there's food here? Dude, you could have smashed a lock and got yourself some disgusting canned tuna. This whole time. My
it
man.
Works.
My
canned
guy?
Spider, though, if you think about it. He's canned it himself for
okay,
later.
Also, I'm betting that there are spiders after this as well. Now I think about it, like...
Nah.
I bet when I go back with the... Like,
there's
food,
no
just, like,
spiders
there's
in this game. Talking
now.
About... There's no
spider. Now there's going to be a giant fuck-off spider here.
Nah.
That's a real horror trope. And it's a really effective one, which is why I talk about it a lot, but like... The returning to a place and things are different thing is real cool. I love that. That is one of my favourite, like, things in horror games. Death is the final unknown.
Indeed. Yes. Spiders over canned tuna. I agree, Joe.
The can is full of spiders.
Yeah. You're saving them for later, for snacks.
It's a snack zone, yeah. Oh, can I run? No, I can't.
I thought you were running.
Yeah, I was running until I got into the crouch again. Hi, spider dog. You having a good day? God, those are some teeth. The graphical limitations have not aided this game.
dusty old bags.
Not gonna lie, I thought it was a pile of massive poop.
I mean, it might be. I'm not really sure what this game's getting at. It's the poop zone.
Go also, down to the poop
zone. I am finding the level design to be a bit mediocre thus far. Like, it's not bad, but it's just sort of like, eh.
It's standard.
Then again, Amnesia was... I got lost in that game several times, which was probably to the game's benefit in a way. Like, wait, I'm dying. I'm losing blood, but I should be okay. How did you lose blood, dude? Have some painkiller.
I'm fine.
Have some painkiller. Have some beef.
Just drink some paint, you'll be fine.
A delicious bottle of Baxter and a lighter. These are quest items, clearly. I don't know why I still have the fucking padlock.
Keep safeties.
No, have a snack, crunch. I'm as fit as can be expected.
Nice.
Ow.
Ow. F.
So everyone enjoying the Penumbra? You're glad you voted for this? Are you glad?
Yes, I am.
You didn't
I
vote?
I am glad I voted
you
for it.
You admit it then.
I just did.
It was you.
It was me.
You did this to me.
I wanted to see you suffer.
Death is in fact the final unknown. I wish there was a manual save button that I knew about. Maybe there is. Okay, backseat gaming allowance. If I'm missing out on the quick save button, please tell me. Because...
Alexa, how could you quick save in Penumbra? I haven't got one, sir.
Good, it'll probably spy on you and steal your lungs.
Nice.
That's what Alexa's there for. Amazon, want your lungs.
Amazon, take my lungs.
F4. I'm very worried about F4 because that if all F4 kills things. Oh no, it could blister human flesh. And I now see it happen.
Oh, I looked away and you looked back and you're dead.
I'm going to mash all the F buttons quick to see if it does anything.
Alt F4. Not Alt F4.
Yeah, no, none of them worked.
Tab
does not work. Load game gives me save spots and auto saves. Okay, so that's the difference between them. So it's no... There's no... It's... There's no need to do this limitation other than the fact that it means dying has consequences, and I'm in two minds about that. Because it means that... It does mean that I have to actually be like, oh, the consequences of my actions exist.
Is it Penumbra Overture?
I don't know the difference between them, I'm going to be honest.
How do I save? In Penumbra Overture. Yeah.
I think it's talked... It's the thingy... Yeah, it's got the...
You can save using the orange glowy trippy things.
Other than that, you have to see your dad once, and that's it.
You have to rely on auto saves. So that's the only other way.
Jesus.
Oh, it says here you can... Now you can quick save by pressing the F4 button and quick load by pressing F5.
I mean, I pressed both F4 and F5, so...
Oh... This was written in 2013, so I don't know if they changed it.
I don't know. I get the feeling that maybe it's because I'm on a specific version of the game. This might be an older patch, actually, if there are patches.
I think they patched it so you could save with F4, but I don't know.
Yeah.
What one you're playing?
I'm playing the... Check, give me a second. Alt tab. Will this break the game? Let's check.
Hey, it's me again. Woo woo woo.
Because the other can't see that. Don't tell them what I'm doing. But yeah, 1.1.1 is apparently the install files I still had on my thing.
Whoa.
Also my girlfriend's messaging me.
All the feet pictures.
God, don't tell my girlfriend I showed you her feet.
Oh, that's so cheesy. I literally got instant diabetes from reading that.
Look, yeah, no, that is our whole chat. We just keep sending each other.
Panda's called Lottie out. Panda called Lottie out in the chat.
Lottie's why are you you guys can't see that she's drunk. This is actually she probably just tweeted that somewhere else. We're not calling my girlfriend out right now.
No. We're good beans.
I can't feel my arms and legs anymore. I'm in trouble. Uh-oh. Well, good job. I can just
take crunch. Some pills.
I'm as fit as can be expected.
Nice.
That's how pain pills work, right?
Yep. Ah.
The photo of booze. Yeah. No, I'm not looking at my girlfriend's Twitter, believe it or not. Oh.
I can.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no. Someone's done a murder. Oh me, oh my. How will I ever cope now? Clunk, 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 clunk.
Let's go and have a look.
Oh, now the door's open and there's blood. Oh, that's nice. That's neat. I think someone's been dragged through here.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Much blood for us. Best answer to dozens. Girls are still down here. I may never get used to that. What is that?
I would like a picture.
Oh, got a key and a pencil. Day 200. Oh, it's the same dude. His plans to record any findings in relation to spiders whom I have shared my existence in the past 8 months. Passed through to my enforced retreat from their basement territory. Not long ago, their behavior became overtly aggressive. I wonder why.
You kept eating them.
And so they're I attempted to barricade the main entrance to their lair and secure myself with one of the small rooms. Imagine just if this was just a comedy.
It is hilarious, not gonna lie.
Yeah. Jesus.
Little spider muncher.
Chat, I can't in part encourage you to do heroin in the It is I'm on Twitch.
Do it. I Don't, can tell you.
No,
do
you
it.
Can't as well. You're in the stream. You can only do it in the chat.
Okay, hang on. All right.
I don't actually know if you can, but
too late.
Oh god damn it! I should pull a street from the basement territory. Not too long ago, over aggressive. Barricade the main entrance. Operational
door locks.
You
know,
I've been recovering from a minor operation. I was supposed to cut myself. Didn't have any anaesthetic and surgical tools I could afford. Less more diligent. Surgical tools are quite well and good, but I trust my penknife. He just stabbed himself to death. Oh.
Ooh.
Actually, no, a simple amputation of a non-vital organ. Is there a thick glue-like substance forming on my tongue? I was forced to accept that I'm infected through constant toxin injection. Day 300. Another century of days comes and goes. That's not how centuries work. Seems like so long since I escaped. At some stage since my last entry, I was attempted to return to whence I came. From my original fleeing scene, fight far worse than the one I face. Time since arrived at Cayman has occurred, blocking any further progress. I was forced to return and accept whatever end life has in store for me. I can feel my aggressive little friend scratching the door to myself. Oh, okay, so yeah, again, this is starting to actually build tension quite nicely. Again, you can see that this is... It's okay. Carving the wood with a knife. Oh, he's the one carving all the spider drawings.
Spider Man.
Fucking
it's Spider-Man's origin story.
Don't get high on Hermione. That's...
I'm just spelling it slightly wrong so Twitch can't get me.
What's this? Are you meat? I think that's meat.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a dead large spider.
Ooh.
That's a god. Yeah, no, they are building the tension. Large spider ever seen with its gut carved open. Delicious.
Scrummy,
everyone's favorite snack. everyone's favourite snack. Penumbra 2 is good. Yeah, the show don't tell gets out. Yeah, you can see that I've played Amnesia, so I know that they've kind of improved, but like. Oh god, opening the door and just seeing.
Hello?
Ooh! Jerky! A delicious treat!
It's not beef jerky, it's spider jerky, we all know this.
Oh god, it might be as well. And you see, oh god, the drag marks leading to a bit you can't get to is. Oh, it's larger for a man. I'd go anywhere near it, even what was. What burrowed out of this tunnel? Scurrying noises.
I don't think it was a giant spider.
Is my gamma maxed out? I don't know, actually. Give me a second.
I am not a giant spider.
Gamma is at 1.0 on my screen. Oh, yeah, you can just make it higher. Hey, everyone, do you want to be able to see way too much? I'm actually going to put it up to 1.5 because that means the stream can see a bit better. I've discovered a thing with still using app paraffin lamps, but yeah, I've discovered that on streams the other side of things is but like yeah, like on Twitch's end, this is going to be a little bit darker than it is on my screen, I believe. I'm not even using the torch right now. I'm just sort of wandering around.
If there's a giant spider, does that mean Lottie's in the game?
No, because she's nice and good.
Yeah, but the spiders are fighting back because they're being eaten by that one dude.
Yeah, the spiders
are
facing adequate revenge.
The spiders
are
actually just protecting themselves.
Still can't shoot ship cam. No, I mean, that's just going to be the game, I think, at this point, Reagan.
I think it's just dark in general.
Oh, yeah, now I've got a functional lighter.
Because it's dark for me on my phone.
No, not quite right. Yeah, if I want to use a lighter now, I guess I can. Oh, no, I don't want to use a lighter because it's clearly part of a puzzle. Let's use the key. Let's hold on to my key. I feel like there's going to be a
key.
Wait, is this door locked? Actually.
Oh, well, yeah, just has stuff behind it.
Hey. Well, it didn't show me not tell me that one, sadly.
And it was like a clear gap. So
yeah.
The door isn't even like fully.
Yeah, that's a bit bad, I'm going to be honest. Might be ideal to block that door. You say, okay. Yeah, no, that's why there's a crack in the door. They should have just put a window there. But yeah, if I lock the door...
Where's a conveniently placed bookcase that you could just push in front of it?
That's what these barrels are, to be fair. Mm. Hey, dog. Oh.
Puppy.
Oh, there's a doggy
puppy
outside. Hey, doggy.
Puppy.
Fuck! Puppy!
I come to eat
fuck
the sword.
Puppy! 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 The dog
puppy
is in fact too strong for me. How far back am I in this fucking game?
Where was that Twitter?
Oh, good.
Pop dogs, I can't really call, but it's like a whole Twitter account dedicated to if you can pet the dogs in certain
videos. Oh, yeah, no, that's a really popular account, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, blocking the door does not help, so I'm just going to do that much and then fucking.
Death, the final frontier.
Fucking. Problem solved!
It's Up Dog.
Oh, what is Up Dog?
Hey.
But yeah, everyone asks what is Up Dog, but no one now what is How Dog.
And no one asks how is Up Dog.
How is Up Dog?
Mm.
How is Up Dog?
And where is Up Dog?
Who is Up Dog?
And when is Up Dog?
Why are we doing this?
Why is Up Dog?
Oh. Oh no, the door is locked. What a shame. Okay, I want to see more games in this sort of... I want an engine with these specific mechanics, like the Amnesia style, picking stuff up and throwing it stuff. Like, this is a fun game system to play around with, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Why is
it?
It
is a... It is the ultimate question. It truly, philosophers ponder with why is up dog?
Why is up dog? We'll never know. Did the dog break the door? Yeah, the dog breaks the door. There we go.
Yeah, it does John Cena
Don't
this
worry.
Way. Yet.
I'm not scared of a dog. I'm a big crawly girl. And by girl, I mean I think this character's a boy.
Not anymore. It's now a girl. We decided.
We've changed. We've transed it.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Oh, a note. The only exit is caved in. I love my workshop. It is too great a hunting ground to let others gorge their faces. One cannot help but feel for those without such a delicate mousy morsels, Mr. Munch. For Red 8, ravenous demon that perished today, and you continue to do so, it's possible that say to run back and sort in the door, and yet Red's mind is working somewhat backwards today.
You thinking what I'm thinking?
The shaft caved in 100 years ago. I'm down. I'm going to die in this thing. There's some industrial explosives, maybe, though.
Yes, all protagonists are female. That's just it. That's the rules. I didn't make it up.
I wonder what that note could mean. I have no clue. What that note could possibly mean.
I have no idea.
I have no clue what that note could possibly mean. The problem is I have to do all this again every time I die and I'm a fucking arse and I don't actually care enough to actually take caution. Oh, some high explosives. Church routine. I don't see a fuse. Don't worry, I know what the game's getting at.
Throw it at the dog.
The dog cannot. I mean, yeah, that might work too. No, you can't see me. I have a barrel in the way. Dog.
He's just puppy. Vibing.
Puppy. You doing okay?
Puppy.
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 Puppy. It's the forbidden yellow.
Poopy? Poopy.
What the pet? The papa.
Poopy. Can I throw a flare? I don't know. I'm trying to work out what I can do to get out.
Right in its face.
I mean, Zippo lighter.
Oh. We have become one with the barrel.
Nothing
strange here.
Someone fucking. Someone play Metal Gear. I wish I could play Metal Gear Solid music on a button press.
Oh yeah.
Dogs. Panda, no. Oh, panda.
A little exclamation mark comes on top of the dog's head,
panda.
And it's like.
Panda. Furries joke, isn't it? Panda.
Panda.
Is that a furries joke? Is that a joke for furdries? You
panda.
Criminal. You big fur boy.
Wait, I'm a furry now. Confirmed by Darkest Dungeon.
God, wait, no, you are. I force furried you. Anyway, yeah, it's just. This will help me out, right? That's.
Yeah, just wedge it in there, it's all
yeah,
good.
Yeah, that's how gravity works.
Yeah.
Old cartwheels and some other scrap. Thanks for... I couldn't have told that on my own. Thanks, Videos Game.
GG.
I really am not feeling this that much. Like, this is just like, the jank is making it real hard to live with. It's, I can see why people would have fond memories of it. I see why people would want to play it, but I'm just, because it's got all the things I liked about Amnesia, but I'd rather just be playing another Amnesia game, you know?
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Notes. My favorite workshop. 2148 backwards. 2148, which means 8412.
Puzzles.
God, that's like the sort of password clue I leave to myself, except fucking mine are better at hiding the actual password. Christ.
And don't write it in all caps.
Oh, fuse! One step closer to making explosives.
Woo!
Hooray! Let's make an explosives. Soaked in bat tricks now. No, not quite right.
Don't light it just yet.
No, definitely light it instantly. One shot.
Touch the lantern thingy.
I will, don't worry. I'm going to save after I've done a load of stuff. Oh, that's... Yeah, that gave me a... But the piece,
gave
I,
me
like,
a frighten.
My imagination, but something definitely catching my eye under these rocks. Fuck yeah. Those holes, he's like, practically all that ice. Okay, so I see. So they're like, oh, you can't climb out, but there's like ice. There's ice in the way. They could have made that clearer, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah, free pickaxe.
Go down in the mine.
Hell yeah. Go. Oh, fuck no. You're a
creeper. Oh yeah. You put your pickaxe number one.
Yeah, I pressed the button wrong. But then now I can swing my pickaxe from side to side. Maybe I can I mine? No. So all things need to be successful as a carpenter.
This game rocks!
Yeah, finally we can be... Go, no. No, we can't. We can't bring back the old horrors.
Panda said the forbidden word.
Looks like they can't... You can't... How do you get these fucking spades off the wall?
Spades?
What's the fucking point of...
It's look, don't touch. It's part of the decor.
Okay.
You know nothing about interior design, Zoe.
It's an old artifact, apparently. Oh, I turned off the Miku-ing, Minerva, because it kept soft. It kept timing people out and deleting all their posts. I didn't like that, so I gave up on that.
As we know, Yogscast is Zoe's mortal enemy.
Yeah, oh, fuck no, I've autosaved. That means I'm gonna die horribly. More spider webs. That's the spider hole. Ceremonial spades, okay, sure.
Yeah.
I bet that feels like a thing dwarves would have, but like at the same, fancy dwarves, I should say. But
yeah, fancy dwarves.
The ones that aren't, you know, a nasty
problematic.
World, yeah, the. Well, I mean, they're definitely everything is problematic. We cannot escape the death. But
They say death is the inevitable end or something.
The death is the fucking forbidden country.
Forbidden.
The final frontier. Electric fence has been put up recently.
Run into it.
I'm very tempted to.
Run straight into
it. No, here's the thing. I don't want to have to redo my save file, and there's a save right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna touch fuzzy and get dizzy. God, I can just see all the dirt on my computer monitor every time I fucking touch it. anyway, time to solve my problem. The way I've been taught by the game to solve the problem.
That's anticlimactic.
You could definitely pull this down, dude. Come on. Set your pickaxe in there.
like do a twizzle and pull. It'll be, it's easy. Death is in fact the final unknown.
Death is the final unknown.
Okay. It's time for more videos, game. I can't open doors holding a pickaxe. That's
rude.
Wait, the fifth wasn't the fifth. There was a Star Trek film that was just like Forbidden Country or something. Like the
one of the newer ones.
No, the sixth original Star Trek one, I think. My dad likes it.
Okay.
It has a transforming lady. A Kirk and Spock, I think, get sent to jail.
Nice.
It's the one where Klingons claim they invented Shakespeare. Hi, friend.
Puppy.
Fuck no! Hit the dog. Hit the.
Oh.
Puppy.
Oh, puppy.
Crunch. Oh no! I have to. Puppy. This dog is just very tough, right? Huh? He's not a fan of me. Right, now I hide back here. Dog.
He flanked you.
Ancient bags of crumbling cement.
Come, go.
God, this fucking undiscovered country. Thank you, mate. Yeah, that was the sixth Star Trek film. It's okay.
I've only seen the new ones.
Yeah. I genuinely think that the second one, The Wrath of Khan, is like a genuinely good movie in its own right. Like,
yeah, it was good.
I think that the best film, if you are a Star Trek fan, is probably 4, because it's fucking funny as shit. It's about going back in time to save whales. And, and it's basically an excuse to make Chekhov say nuclear weapon. And have Spock act weird because he doesn't have his memory at that point. And... it's pretty good.
As a fan, not a fan of sci-fi, enjoyed Wrath of Khan?
Really?
Star Trek one.
Yeah, the main problem with Wrath of Khan is that it's...
Is that the one with Benedict?
Yeah, like that one's not very popular because it's a bad remake of... of the second one. That is a bad remake of... Wrath of Khan, the movie. It's Into Darkness is the name of it.
It's that one.
Yeah. Which means it's not very popular on anyone who's... Because a lot of the things you need to get about that film that are good are just references to a better film.
Puppy!
Oh, my puppy.
Yeet! For some reason, though, I have like a weird knack of enjoying films that are like terrible.
I kind of enjoyed it when I watched it, and then I thought about it for 5 seconds. And I was like, no, this is kind of crap.
I genuinely enjoyed the Green Lantern, which is hilarious.
Oh, I kind of enjoyed the Green Lantern film. Like, it's a mess, but it's an enjoyable mess actually. It just everything looks like garbage. If I bye, puppy.
Bye, papa.
Am I dying? No, I'm fine. I'm doing good. I'm chill.
One thing my mum's watching recently is Battlestar Galactica.
Ooh, the modern one, I presume?
I don't know what one it is. She's just been watching it a lot.
Yeah, there's an old, like, 70s or 80s Battlestar Galactica as well. I've been meaning to watch that because I really enjoyed it. I actually really enjoyed the remake one. The ending's a bit wonky because it clearly wasn't the ending they had planned. But, like... It's fine. It's not the end of the world if your ending's a little bit shit, guys. Come on. The rest of the show is still pretty good.
It's alright. Fan fiction will fix that.
Well, I've shoved a thing in a thing.
Smack it with a pick. Come on.
This is how we solve all of our problems here in the mine. I can't ignore the igniter soap string. It has to be a proper fuse.
Ugh.
No, not quite right. I mean, I could have just used a rope in general, but now I need another thing, I guess. So I'm going to go back to the save point quick. Again, this dog isn't scaring me. in the way that the amnesia monsters did. So it's just sort of annoying me. It's the tattletale problem of I'm not scared of this, so it's just like...
I don't find Telltale scary.
That was my point with Telltale, is that it became... even what it had going for it became unscary by the end, because I was just frustrated with Mama Telltale. Also, Wim Shatner's a bit of a shit.
Papa!
Oh, hi, doggy!
Papa!
I like that the ideal solution is to whack a dog with a pickaxe and run away. Anyway, I've got a crunch.
Crunch lapel.
God, the one why thing do I like about crunch. Don't crunch into painkillers, dude.
Eat the pot. Just the pot, not pills. Just pot. One thing I like about
Shatner's definitely
Star Trek is the really over-exaggerated acting that they do that came like a meme.
Oh yeah, no, Shatner is not the best actor by any means.
It was like it was so bad it was good.
Oh, I guess that this was a World War. The bunker was World War II. Okay, sure. But Shatner's a total piece of shit now, which is really sad because Star Trek was always quite progressive and neat in that regard. Oh, a death mine, hallucinogenic.
Yeah, Leonard Nimoy.
Results of chemical testing. Okay, so Nimoy. Nimoy was cool. He went dead. That was sad. I think most people involved are cool, as far as I know.
You always get like at least one.
Fucking was his face. The actual producer dude is kind of a piece of shit as well. I'm sure, and there's a lot of actors involved with the series from like there's so many fucking spin-offs. So, there's definitely at least somebody. They've definitely spawned that dog right next to me just to piss me off, huh?
Puppy.
Poopy.
Poopy. Smack.
Poopy.
He just doesn't care. He just doesn't like walking up.
Poopy. I'm fed up with this game.
I'm done.
Oh, Christ. I'm not. I can't
blame
this. This is just
Shatner.
Too old.
It was Shatner's fault.
Shatner's
why
bad.
He's a shit boy. He's a bastard.
The only good thing that Shatner's ever done is embarrassing himself. And also Star Trek 2, which I do still attest is actually a pretty good film. But, even though he's acting still hammy, I think the director was good, used him well there.
Who was the guy that's in Big Bang Theory? That was in Star Trek.
Fucking.
He plays D&D.
That could be many people. Oh, Will Wheaton. Oh, yeah, no, he
Will
was.
Will Wheaton.
He's infamous for blocklisting too many people on Twitter nowadays, but he's. He's at worst kind of a shitty liberal, and that's about it. Like, he's not bad. He's not, like, an outwardly nasty person. He's just kind of clumsy sometimes, in my opinion.
I literally only know him because
I liked his board game show. It was quite
D&D.
Good.
But, and the board game YouTube videos.
Anyway, I'm going to swap to another game because I can't cope with any more of Penumbra right now. No. I'm very tempted to see what the other Penumbras are like, but also, like, I really don't, if that makes sense. Oh, people talking about the Ballad of Bilbo Baggins in the background. Oh, dear. Leonard Nimoy is just a music video where he's a retiree smoking... Oh, God, no, I need to actually... You know what? I need to show... chat this. I've already considered the copyright in this video fucked up, so actually let's fuck it. Let's swap to screen capture for a second, and I'm gonna YouTube. Where is it? God. William Shatner. Common people. Here we go. Oh, thanks, person who added this prompt to the start of the video. That's Neverhood sound effects. What the shit? Why are you Neverhood sound effecting at me?
really learning slowly.
She came from Greece. She had a thirst for knowledge. She studied sculpture at St. Martin's College. She told me that her dad was loaded. I said,
I'm both Sally and find the real video. She said, fine. And also, fucking and glad that I found time, this said, shit.
I want to live like common people. I want to do whatever common people do. I want to sleep with common people. I want to sleep with common people like you. Well, what else could I do? I said, I'll see what I can do. I took her to a supermarket. I don't know why, but I had to start it somewhere. So it started there.
Space hell!
You've got no money. She just laughed.
Exciting thing,
girl. Yeah. Well, I can't see anyone else smiling in here. Are you sure? You want to live like common people? You want to see whatever common people see? You want to sleep with common people? You want to sleep with common people like me? But she didn't understand. She just smiled and held my hand. People. You'll never do whatever common people do. You'll never fail like common people. You'll never watch your life slide out of you and dance and drink and screw. Because there's nothing else to do.
Someone's showing off those Star Trek figures.
Yes. That camera work is beautiful.
I need you to understand.
Sing along with the common people. Sing along, and it might just get you through.
Stop laughing.
Laugh along, even though they're laughing at you and the stupid things that you do.
The monitor.
That fool is cool.
This is deliberate. This is a deliberate parody. I love it.
They'll bite you and never warn you. Look out. They'll tear your insides out. Because everybody hates a tourist.
Everybody hates a tourist. Especially one who thinks it's all such a lie.
Yeah, and the chip stains grease.
The worst thing
about
this is. This is the best song that William Shatner did.
Wait
a minute, this is both versions mashed together.
Roaches climb the wall. You called your dad.
I just had the realization.
Stop it all, yeah. You'll never live like common people.
Both of them, I think.
You'll never do what common people do. You'll never fail like common people. You'll never watch your life slide out of you. And dance and drink and screw. Because there's nothing else to do.
That video is 10 years old.
It is. I'm putting this in my share post list.
Nice.
And my please, I'm putting this in the stream list. That was
beautiful.
An experience. The thing about that is, Common People is a song about poverty tourism. Being sung by a rich celebrity. It's fucking amazing.
Yeah, what in fresh hell? I agree.
Anyway, do you want to do Penumbra 2, everyone? Penumbra. Here's the thing. Rocket Man is funny. Like, but Common People is both listenable and fucking hilarious because it is a rich man singing a song about poverty tourism. First person. Malem. I do have Secret Little Haven somewhere, I believe. Give me a second. It's not a horror game, but I don't think I can cope with any more horror. Have I actually downloaded it? Yeah, I have. I've got it downloaded already. I'm not sure if I... That's going to be a real emotional experience. I'm not sure I can cope with it right now, in truth. You keep telling me to... I mean, this stream does very much seem to be for the Vine right now.
Do it for the Vine.
Gotta be honest. But,
I keep reading your conversation. It's very funny.
Yeah.
All right,
please stop
all
dunking on me
picks.
For being in love with my girlfriend. See?
All the feet pics. So many feet pics.
I'm sorry,
Zoe. Zoe, some of us are still single. It's upsetting.
Jesus Christ. Okay. I'm going to do a vote again, I guess. That's probably the way to solve this.
Democracy!
Democracy solves all of my problems. Next game. I'm going to give this one a minute because I'm not going away for it.
Next game. Penumbra 2.
Penumbra 2, or... Correct. What's another? I need to do another joke option, which everyone will vote for.
Yeah.
Also, I inexplicably, in the middle of my screen, GeForce Ready Driver is available has just popped up. Anyway, nice. There we go. There's another poll. Let's... I can't play my own game. I can't play Honey Pop.
Play.
I'm not into feet, you asses. That's the thing. If it was a thing I was actually into, I'd just be suspiciously quiet about it. But no, I'm not. You
guys, there's so many feet pics. So many.
Okay, play my game, but it is not a game with. It has a little bit of replay value, but like watching someone play it is basically playing it yourself in truth, which means I don't want to play it because it means that you've all seen the whole content. I will give you secret facts about my characters that I made up, though. I will, in fact, ruin your headcanons. What are the results of this poll?
Your results.
Watch Dogs 2, lol. Okie dokie.
I voted for Penumbra 2, just saying.
Well, I mean, fair.
because no one voted for it, I totally didn't vote for it. I voted for Watch Dogs 2. Watch Doggos 2.
Yeah, this is penance for our dog murder in the previous game.
Yeah. The doggos made us do it.
The dog has taken
revenge.
I say
us, it's just you and I'm watching you suffer, but you know.
I genuinely didn't expect Watch Dogs 2 to win, I've got to be honest. Wait, I also voted for Penumbra 2, but my mouse clicked on Watch Dogs? I can't redo the vote.
It wouldn't have won anyway because it was three votes. It would have done two votes against one. So
I'm mad at all of you.
Yay!
Jesus Christ! Where's my controller? There's my controller. See, if you own a free copy of Watch Dogs 2, I think there's multiplayer in this, but I'm not sure how it works.
don't own a free copy of Watch Dogs 2, unfortunately.
Fuck Ubisoft. Oh, god damn it, there's a Uplay update. Yeah. Ah! Oh, the blemming has begun.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, gee, I lost count.
Gong. Gong.
Blem.
Gong. Gong.
Minerva's gonna drown you.
She tries. He keeps asking if I want to let Uplay do things. I don't, but I have to make the game install. Oh, Christ, my water has run out now. Oh, Minerva. Okay, I'm gonna have to
meet
me. Blim. Okay, so I'm raising the price of hydrate. Where's the button for this? Look, with Blem, it's funny to spam it. I deliberately put that there to be spammed. The problem with hydrate is that I physically have to drink, and it hurts.
It's painful. I could suggest a poll. I have enough points to suggest a poll if I wanted to.
Yeah, you probably do. Please don't right now because I'm dealing with things. Blem.
I'm saving up for Blim. Donkey Kong. I want to summon.
Oh
Donkey
fuck!
Kong.
Watch Dogs 2 has stolen my mouse.
it taketh.
Blim, 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 blim. You summon Donkey Kong on Sunday. Please don't. I can't cope with Donkey Kong being here.
It's alright, I haven't got enough points yet, but when I get enough...
Channel points. God, please let me fucking... The clip will still be around, hopefully, but...
Quick, before they start
spamming hydrate. I'm literally going to have to... Yeah, I'm doubling the price of hydrate quick to 400 because I can't cope with this. I'm pausing redemptions until I can fix this. I'm sorry.
The blems have broken the stream.
I need to reboot it to make sure it's working again.
It's back.
Yeah. No, I think that's fixed now. There we go.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Just God, no fucking Yeah, if you want to do the poll or any Donkey Kong stuff, let me boot the game up first, please.
No, I'm saving up for Donkey Kong. I haven't got enough yet.
Yeah, Donkey Kong is a fun one.
I've only got 4.3k at the moment.
I don't know whether to hope that someone will eventually actually get enough to end the stream or not, because I will. The problem with that is I fucking will.
I don't know if I'll get to that much, though. Mm. So use a ton to, like, spam... Blem at one point.
Screen. Yeah, that's the thing about Blem. It keeps the prices down.
It stops people from trying to end stream.
It does. Yeah. It's oh, save it to 5 minutes in. That's the worst thing. The thing is, I will end the stream. You don't know what power you play with, Minerva. Also, oh god, the Streamlabs chat message, quickly test. I think it's disconnected from chat on... Ugh. Watch Dogs 2 doesn't have enough content? Oh, fucking hell. I don't know what's a joke and what's not anymore. I have 3 separate sets of messages on all 3 of the windows of the chat I can see. I do test on this one again, quick as well.
I see that.
Yeah, that's really wonking out. A couple of marks and a dress. Fuck. Worst game ever.
Disgusting. Terrible game. absolutely.
I'm just gonna. I need to add a thing to my stream quick. Before I go on. Can I just? I need to copy this from another window. I apologize for fucking around. I forgot I changed it to that. Fuck, I just want to copy the text.
Yeah, the one with Antifa Granny is not out yet.
Oh no, that sucks. But yeah, mainstream. Paste duplicate. And I'm just going to change the text quickly. If I can remember how. There we go.
That Watchdogs Legion, is that what it's called? The newest one?
Yeah, I believe so. Anyway, yeah, just making my thoughts perfectly clear on the on Ubisoft quick.
Yes.
Yeah, note cam is...
spitting your facts.
Sometimes you just gotta shit on some people, you know?
I think you need to make it really big and just across the whole screen.
The whole screen! Yeah. No, really if I'm playing this, I'm playing it with a fuck Ubisoft on the line. But
yep.
Where are we? I can probably also move C onto screen share properly. Quick. Rather than...
Ooh.
Yeah, hopefully this will mean you only see the game now. I hope. Fortunately, there's new clothes shops all around San Francisco.
Yes.
Uplay cracks are more stable than the real Uplay. They probably are, huh? Anyway, I can buy emotes. I can lol at people. And I don't play the fucking game yet. New content installed. I got this game for free, for the record.
I will say that Ubisoft sucks, but there's one character in Watch Dogs 2 that's like my
favorite. The thing is, if they haven't made good games, I wouldn't be... No, I would be as angry, but it's personal when it's something you like, if that makes sense.
The guy with the mask that has the little electrical emoticons on, he's my favourite.
No, at any point in time, you change difficulty level. Change difficulty
Wrench.
To...
Is it Wrench?
Game
Wrench
pad.
Is such a good boy. He's the best boy.
Hard. On. Make sure everything's at good quality quick. I don't know what the... Again, I don't know what these mean. I'm in the game and I hate it. But we are ultra, right? There we go. Colour. Yeah, it's fine. On my end. Tell me if there's any issues on everyone else's end. Audio and language. So, just make sure the subtitles are on. Good.
Yeah, I meant Daft Punk Panda.
Yeah. Oh. Also, I've just realised that this is going to have copyrighted music, isn't it? So I'm going to do a quick stream up, stream down, quick. Just to make sure the VOD gets only adds on one section of it. Oh, no, wait, no, fuck it. Actually, I'm not going to do that because I already played the Common People song. That's definitely getting flagged. I don't care.
I no longer give two fucks.
Ubisoft racist? Who would have thought?
Who? What? Why, though? Why Updog?
Yeah, why is Updog still, yeah. Why is it limited to your 3 saves on PC? Fucking heck. What about my Ubisoft name is still Dalek Cat. That's an interesting feature. I thought I'd change that, but I guess I don't care enough to at this point. Wait, that's a... There's a fucking picture. Rage face.
It's a meme.
It's a meme.
It's a meme.
God, this stream is such a fucking shitpost in general.
I want to see my boy Daft Punk.
Oh yeah, that used to be my username on most things. And then I decided that Terry Nation's estate would probably, if I got big enough, probably get angry at me. So I decided
against
it. Isn't
that your... Was that your, no, it wasn't your Pokemon Go name, was it?
Oh, no, that's... I think that's always been level 100 Magikarp, because I like the Pokemon joke. But,
Vin Diesel.
Oh, no, specifically the Dalek is wearing a hat, me.
Yeah.
It's still my icon. Wait, Panda, did you not know I was Dalek Hat? Do you think we were two separate people this whole time?
Panda's having a revelation right now. Their mind is blown.
He just thought I vanished and got replaced by someone else.
Consider this your 10 second initiation, Retro.
You're going to hold me accountable for my past crimes now. To accept it. Oh, what? To bypass Bloom security doors. Oh, I'm just in this then, huh?
Then
find and erase your personal CTOS profile.
I mean, I do.
Whatever they have on me, it's all bullshit. And I'm sick of getting harassed for it.
All the more reason for a purge. We'll be watching.
Trying to keep up.
I do appreciate that I'm just straight into this.
Together to set the mood. Yeah.
Limb.
Hope you like it.
You don't have
to blem. I'll help you out with the blems.
You no, it only can survive blem, I think. Oh, if I... Yeah, I haven't played the game.
Beep, 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 beep,
beep. Boom, ba-dum. Hey, go have a nap, friend. Nap time.
Sleepy time.
Have a nice sleepy.
Beeps.
Oh, I can... that's a good menu. I have gun. I can shoot. Do I want to shoot? No. Not particularly. I'm a good boy in this game, I guess.
Yes.
Can I... How do I... Do I just jump off a fucking building? Whoop.
Yeet.
That's how I do. This is not a stun pistol, right? Is this a stun pistol?
It looks like a taser.
Well...
I guess it was a taser.
I guess. If it's not a taser, I'm murdering some people, so that'll be bad.
Murder in a Ubisoft game? Never.
This game may have raised the expectations about 3D printing. It only counts if Zoe bled the air.
I see I don't matter. Ugh.
See, you're technically not affiliated with me, which is how you get away with so much. You are not an employee of Zoe Incorporated.
No.
Yeah, I'm also... I can't... I am trying to view this through... Actor... I took a picture.
Sexy.
I won't do a hack. Do I? Do I turn it off?
I think it's like lagging for people.
Is it? Oh, fucking hell. Right, let's see if I can do anything about that quickly. Why is it? Oh, 100% of frames have been skipped? What the shit?
No frames for you.
Yeah, no, that's happening on my end too. I'm not sure why. See, can you tell chat I'm dealing with it?
Zoe is dealing with it. Wait, hang on. I'll write it in.
Yeah. I don't know what's happening. I might have to drop a video feed for you. That might help.
That's chill.
Sorry.
I'm watching it on my phone anyway, so it's fine.
Yeah, but
I sent a little emoji.
Yeah, stream has disconnected trying to reconnect 11 minutes ago. Don't blem while I'm fixing.
Blem's a band.
Blem!
Just write it in the chat.
Yeah. Just to be sure. But yeah, I don't know what to... Is it going now? Is it better? I don't know what to do other than...